बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। इन द प्रीवियस लेसन वी हैड स्टार्टेड आवर चैप्टर प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ प्री फॉर्मुलेशन एंड डोजेज फॉर्म डिज़ाइन। इन द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ दैट चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दैट चैप्टर इन टुडेज क्लास, दैट इज नीड फॉर डोजेज फॉर्म डिज़ाइन। So let's start with the background first of the dosage form design. An important milestone in the drug discovery and development process is the discovery of an active compound, which is a long multifaceted process. The evolution of new chemical entity has vastly increased over the last few decades, mainly because of the commencement of high throughput methods for drug synthesis and screening. Drug development primarily involves the investigation on lead molecules, which are identified in drug discovery stages. A lead compound must voyage through a series of investigations and experimentations to provide a researcher early efficacy and safety evaluations. Ideally, drug must be properly absorbed into the systemic circulation, distributed to the proper site of action, metabolized efficiently and effectively, and excreted well from the body, and should be non-toxic. The pre-formulation studies helps the researchers to scrutinize the lead compounds early in the discovery process. The lead molecule is used to generate specific chemical compounds with the optimal physicochemical, pharmaceutical, pharmacokinetic, pharmacodynamic, pharmacological, and safety characteristics of the compound. The potential for these features can be predicted from reasonably interim preclinical and clinical studies, and for the proper and speedy drug development. It is obligatory to select a compound with favorable pharmaceutical and pharmacological properties. A new compound, after its identification, must undergo a complete procedure of drug development, and before it can be transformed into its proper dosage form. So let's repeat. A new compound, after its identification, must undergo the complete procedure of drug development, and before it can be transformed into a proper dosage form. So it is important to characterize the physicochemical, pharmacodynamic, and pharmacological properties or pharmacological screening of the new drug substance for the development of safe and sound dosage form. The objective of formulation development are to ensure accurate dosage and dosing regimen to present the drug substance in a convenient form for the patient, and to increase the stability of the drug to prolong its shelf life. The drug substances are seldom administered alone. Rather, they are given as part of the formulation in combination with one or more non-medicinal agents. Those non-medicinal agents are actually serving as the specialized pharmaceutical functions, or they serve the varied and specialized pharmaceutical functions. Selective use of these non-medicinal agents is referred to as pharmaceutical ingredients or excipients that produces the dosage form of various types. These are the basics of dosage form design, and these are the very few basic steps that we are now going to study that you have already previously studied in your previous classes. We are just repeating the whole terminologies and the whole concepts in this class. So this is all the basics. I am not going into the detail of it, the depth of it, because the depth would actually be the repetition of all the processes. The pharmaceutical ingredients solubilize, suspend, thicken, dilute, emulsify, stabilize, preserve color and flavor, and fashion the medicinal agents into efficacious and appealing dosage forms. Each type of dosage form is unique in its physical and pharmaceutical characteristic. These varied preparations provide the manufacturing and compounding pharmacists with the challenges of formulation, and on the other hand to the physician with the choice of the drug and delivery system to prescribe. How a dosage form is defined? A dosage form is defined as a physical form of a drug, such as solid, liquid or gas, by which it is delivered in its proper form to particular sites of action within the body. Common dosage forms, as you all know, include solutions, tablets, capsules, semi-solids, injectables and aerosols. A dosage form is very much necessary because there are certain conditions where only a particular route of administration is feasible or preferable. Like, for example, in the case of dysphagia, nausea and vomiting, oral administration is not particularly suitable and has to opt for other routes of administration like parenteral, topical or inhalation routes. Similarly, in case of joint pain, local application or topical application is more preferable rather than an oral route of administration. So therefore, transforming a drug into a proper dosage form not only provides various advantages like ease of handling, ease of administration, better stability, but it also provides it also leads to a better therapeutic efficacy and bioavailability of the drug. What are the main characteristics of the dosage form? The proper design and formulation of a dosage form requires considerations of the physical, chemical and biological characteristics of all the drug substances and pharmaceutical ingredients to be used in fabricating the product. The drug and pharmaceutical materials must be compatible with one another to produce a drug product that is stable, efficacious, attractive, easy to administer and safe. The product should be manufactured with appropriate measures of quality control, and it should be packaged in containers that keep the product stable throughout the shelf life. The product should be labeled to promote the current use and be stored under conditions that contribute the maximum shelf life. The main topic of our study. What is the need for a dosage form? This is a flow chart that explains the need for a dosage form. An active pharmaceutical compound alone is nothing. Unless it is actually incorporated with excipients and combined to form a certain dosage form. This combination of product needs certain manufacturing steps and manufacturing procedures. And again, all these procedures and processes needs control, validation and optimization until unless it leads to a particular dosage form. The dosage form that has been prepared by all these processes must meet the quality, safety and efficacy requirements of the regulatory bodies, and particularly of the form or route of administration through which it is going to be administered into the patients. The potent nature and low dosage of most of the drugs in use today precludes any expectations that the general public could safely obtain the appropriate dose of a drug from the bulk material. Most of the drug substances are administered in milligram quantities. These milligram quantities are very small to be weighed on anything, but a sensitive prescription or electronic analytical balance is a must to weigh all these milligram or minute quantities of the potent drug substances. For example, how could the lay person accurately obtain from a bulk supply of 325 milligram of aspirin found in the common tablet? It is not possible. Yet compared with other many drugs, the dose of aspirin is quite reasonable. Like, see this chart. It actually gives you these drugs with relatively low usual dosages. The examples are given over here. Like, for example, clotrimazole has a usual dosage of 10 milligram and it is an antifungal drug. The smallest dose over here is of ethinyl estradiol. Ethinyl estradiol have a usual dose of 0.05 milligram. When we compare it with the drugs which have higher usual doses like aspirin, 325 milligram, this is a very minute quantity that is actually impossible for a layman or for a normal person to weigh. For example, here in ethinyl estradiol, that is 0.05 milligram. It is actually the one of the 6,500th bar amount of aspirin in an aspirin tablet. Just consider it in another way, that 6,500 ethinyl estradiol tablets each containing 0.05 milligram of drug can be made from an amount of estradiol, ethinyl estradiol, which is actually equal to the amount of aspirin in just one standard tablet. When the dose of the drug is minute, as with the ethinyl estradiol, solid dosage forms such as tablets and capsules must be prepared with fillers or diluents so that the dosage unit is large enough to pick up with the fingertips. There are other additional reasons for the need of dosage form. The first is to protect the drug substance from the destructive influences of atmospheric oxygen or humidity. For this reason, we prepare coated tablets and sealed ampoules. Enteric coated tablets are formulated to protect the drug substances from the destructive influence of gastric acids after oral administration. Likewise, capsules, coated tablets, and flavored syrups are formulated to conceal the bitter, salty, and offensive taste or odor of the drug substances. The suspensions are formulated to provide the liquid preparations of substances that are either insoluble or unstable in the desired vehicle. Likewise, syrups and solutions are formulated to provide a clear liquid dosage form of substances. Various controlled release tablets, capsules, and suspensions are being made to provide the rate controlled drug action. To provide optimal drug action from topical administration sites, ointments, creams, transdermal patches, and ophthalmic, ear, and nasal preparations are being formulated. And to provide for the insertion of a drug into one of the body orifices, rectal or vaginal suppositories are formulated. To provide for placement of drug directly into the bloodstream or blood body tissues, injections or injectable dosage forms are designed. To provide for optimal drug action through inhalation therapy, there are inhalants and inhalation aerosols available in the market. This table shows the types of dosage form with merits and demerits. The dosage forms are classified in many ways, but here we are actually classifying them on the basis of their phases. Like solid dosage forms contains tablets, capsules, lozenges, chewing gums, pellets and films. The merits of these solid dosage forms are dose accuracy, stability of the drug, portability, uniformity of the dose, reproducibility, high mechanical strength, temper resistance, masking the taste and odor of the drug components, and they are easy to pack, handle, and they are easy to transport. But still, there are certain demerits of these solid dosage forms. They are not suitable for the patients who are unconscious. They are not suitable for the patients who are non-compliant to these sort of medications due to difficulty in swallowing. There are certain formulation complications associated with these type of dosage forms. They are not preferable for acid labile and stomach irritant drugs. The other type of dosage forms are liquid dosage forms. These liquid dosage forms are again subdivided into two parts based upon their phase. The one type of liquid dosage form is monophasic, and that includes solutions, elixirs and syrups. And the other type of liquid dosage forms are biphasics, that include suspensions and emulsions. Again, they do have certain merits and demerits, like advantages and disadvantages. These liquid dosage forms are easy to swallow and manufacture. They do provide fast absorption and in turn improves the bioavailability of the medicinal compound which are incorporated into these dosage forms. They do have less processing steps in their manufacturing, and they require less excipients when they are compared with the solid dosage forms, specifically tablets. The disadvantages includes the non-uniformity of the doses. They are prone to microbial attack. They are bulky in nature, so that makes them difficult for transport. And there are chances of breakage during shipment and transportation due to the containers in which they are packaged usually. They are unsuitable for unpleasant taste and obnoxious odor drugs, and they are less stable as compared to the solid dosage forms. The other type of dosage forms are semi-solid dosage forms, and these semi-solid dosage forms include creams, gels, liniments, lotions and ointments. The merits include these dosage forms are easy to use. They are more stable than liquid dosage forms, and avoidance of first pass hepatic metabolism is actually possible through these type of dosage form as they are administered locally, and the patient convenience is also possible, and that makes them compliant for the usage. Demerits include the difficulty in handling of these dosage forms, and there are certain chances of contaminations when they are packaged with certain type of containers or when they are applied with the hand or finger. They are more prone to environmental effects, and they may cause certain staining and irritations on the localized area where they may be applied. The last type of dosage form based upon the phase include gaseous dosage forms. They do have merits and demerits as well. Gaseous dosage forms are easy to handle and they are convenient to use. The withdrawal of dose without contamination is possible due to the packaging containers. Environmental protection of unstable drugs is again possible due to the container packaging. They provide medications to the local area, specifically they provide a localized effect, and dose adjustment is possible via meter dose containers or meter dose valves. They are tamper proof as well, but still they do contain certain demerits. because they provide all these type of protections and benefits, they are expensive. They may create environmental hazards due to the presence of chlorofluorocarbons in them. They do have certain non-reliable performance in certain instances, and they have a limited safety, and dosing is actually not reproducible. So what are the general considerations in dosage form design? Before formulating a drug substance into a dosage form, the desired product must be determined in so far as possible to establish the framework of for product development. Then various initial formulations of the product are developed, and the formulated and developed initial products are examined for the desired features, for example drug release profiles, bioavailability and clinical effectiveness, and for pilot plant studies and production scale up as well. We have defined the scale up in the previous class already. The formulation that best meets the goals of the product is selected to be its master formula. Each batch of the product subsequently prepared must meet the specifications established in the master formula. There are many different forms into which a medicinal agent may be placed for the convenient and efficacious treatment of diseases. Most commonly, certain manufacturers prepare a single drug substance in several dosage forms and stands for the efficacious and convenient treatment of diseases. Like here in this example, a single dosage form of Panadol containing paracetamol is available in tablets. It is available in suspension and it is also available in infant drops. Before a medicinal agent is formulated into one or more dosage forms, among the factors considered are such of therapeutic matters as the nature of the illness, the manner in which it is treated locally or through systemic action, and the age and anticipated condition of the patient. If the medication is intended for systemic use and oral administration is desired, tablets or capsules are usually prepared. Because tablets and capsules are easily handled by the patients, and these type of dosage forms are the most convenient in self-administration of medications. That means they do not require any specific technique or any specific specialized individual for the administration of tablets and capsules. If a drug substance has application in emergency, or the drugs which are used in the emergency conditions in which the patient may be comatose or unable to take oral medications, parenteral form of dosage forms like injectables are more preferred and they are prepared. There are many other examples of therapeutic situations that affects the dosage form design that include the motion sickness, nausea and vomiting, for which tablet and skin patches are used for prevention, and suppositories and injections for treatment. The age of the patients for an intended therapy also plays an important role in the dosage form design. Say for example, for infants and children younger than 5 years of age, pharmaceutical liquids rather than solid forms are preferred for oral administration. And these liquids, which are flavored aqueous solutions, syrups or suspensions, are usually administered either directly into the infant or child's mouth by drop, spoon or oral dispenser, or by mixing it with the food. Here are the examples of the dosing instruments or dosing cups that are being used for the administration of drugs to the infants, like dosing cups, oral syringes with colored cap, dosing spoons, oral dosing syringes for infants, and medicinal droppers. They are actually supplied with the dosage forms like syrup, suspensions and emulsions that are to be administered in infants and children younger than 5 years of age. When a young patient has a productive cough or is continuously vomiting or gagging or simply rebellious, there may be some questions as to how much of the medicine is administered is swallowed and how much is expectorated. In certain conditions or in such conditions, injections may be required or injections may be preferred. Infant size rectal suppositories may also be employed, although drug absorption from the rectum is often erratic. During childhood and even adulthood, a person may have difficulty swallowing solid dosage forms, especially uncoated tablets. For this reason, some medications are formulated, such as chewable tablets. Many of these tablets are comparable in texture to an after-dinner mint and break down into a pleasant-tasting creamy material. There are newly available tablets which are called as orally disintegrating tablets. They dissolve in the mouth in about 10 to 15 seconds, and this allows the patient to take a tablet but swallow a liquid. Capsules have been found by many to be more easily swallowed than whole tablets. If the capsule is moistened in the mouth before it is swallowed, it actually becomes slippery and it readily slides down the throat with water. A teaspoon full of gelatin dessert, liquid candy or syrup placed in the mouth and partially swallowed before placing the solid dosage form in the mouth aids in swallowing the capsules. If a person has difficulty swallowing a capsule, the contents may be emptied into a spoon mixed with jam, honey or other similar foods to mask the taste of the medication and then swallowed. Medications that are intended for oral for the elderly are commonly formulated into oral liquids, or they may be extemporaneously prepared into an oral liquid by the pharmacist. However, certain tablets and capsules that are designed for the controlled release should not be crushed or chewed because that would interfere with their integrity and intended performance. Many patients, particularly the elderly, take multiple medications daily. The more distinctive the size, shape and color of the solid dosage form, the easier is the proper identification of the medications. Medication errors or errors in taking medications among the elderly or geriatric population occur frequently because of their multiple drug therapies and impaired eyesight. Dosage forms that allow reduced frequency of administration without sacrificing the efficiency are particularly advantageous in this instances. In dealing with the problem of formulating a drug substance into a proper dosage form, a pharmacist employs knowledge gained through experience with other chemically similar drugs and through the proper use of physical, chemical, biological and pharmaceutical sciences. In the early stages of any formulation development, studies to collect the basic information on the physical and chemical characteristics of the drug substance is required. The basic studies are the pre-formulation work needed before actual product formulation begins. This is the main topic that we are going to focus on for the development and design procedures of a new dosage form or for the novel dosage forms. That's all for today. This whole lecture was referenced from chapter 4 of Ansel Pharmaceutical Dosage Form and Drug Delivery System. I will be uploading that chapter on HULMS as well. So you may refer the presentation as well as the chapter. Although I have tried to make this presentation a more elaborative one in order to understand it better, and it would be easier for you to read it out and listen to it and understand it well rather than focusing on the bullet points. The The next lesson or the next topic of our study would be the pre-formulation studies. This topic would again be further subdivided into three classes. The pre-formulation studies are basically focused on three different parameters, and we will be dividing this whole topic into three lectures. For questions and queries, and the discussion forum is open on HULMS. You can ask any question regarding this topic or the previous topic that is difficult for you to understand, and then I will answer you on that forum. If that is not possible for you, you can actually email me on my official email ID, taking a snapshot of that particular portion that you do not understand or you need an elaboration of it. Thank you for listening to the lecture. Take care of yourself and your family around. May Allah bless you. Allah Hafiz.